good afternoon to everybody present here. Today, we have gathered here for our sixth session of the SDR Knowledge Series in association with Chitnavis Center. The SDR Knowledge Foundation is a Section 8 company and believes in improving the quality of the society by increasing the culture of philanthropy and the welfare of the people and to also make the world a better place to live in. Today, we'll talk about the importance of values in personal, family, organization, and national life by Dr. D.R. Karthikeyan. He has been the former director of the Central Bureau of Investigation, Special Director General, Central Reserve of Police Force, and currently he is the Director General of the National Human Rights Commission of India. So, a number of cultural aspects influence the way we interact with other people, including national culture, gender culture, corporate culture, and various communication styles. All these elements influence how we work, conduct work, our behavior and style, our use of language, how we solve challenges, problems, and conflicts, how we negotiate, and how we go about creating relationships. Diving a bit deeper on that, all of the above is driven by our values. Values and beliefs are learned in national culture and they may be unconscious. You may not be aware of your own values and beliefs until you are confronted with someone from a different country or a different origin. We have a tendency to judge others' behavior based on our own cultural norms, the lens we see through. And here, we have lots of opportunities for potential conflict, misunderstandings, and miscommunications. Different values lead to different behavior you may or may not understand. It is important that we thrive to learn and appreciate these differences in order to work effectively with people from other cultures. In this session of Knowledge Series, audiences will be in a position to get the details of the theory on how values are important in all areas of life. It is important to give a living example for this. D.R. Karthikeyan was born to an agricultural family in a small village in Devarayapuram in Coimbatore district. He obtained a B.Sc. degree in chemistry and had competitive examinations for senior civil services. He joined the Indian Police Service in 1964. Mr. Karthikeyan went through extensive training in that field, which included being trained at the National Police Academy in Mount Abu. He also served in a number of important positions: Deputy Commissioner of Police, Head of Karnataka State Police Academy, Inspector General of Police, Central Reserve Police Force, Southern Sector at Hyderabad, and many more. The investigative skill and the liaise on record by the full bench of the Supreme Court of India. Mr. Karthikeyan was first secretary in the Embassy of India, Moscow, Russia, from 1974 to 1977. He was stationed in Sydney, Australia, from 1985 to 1989, before the assassination of the Prime Minister, Mr. Rajiv Gandhi. He has also authored a book, Triumph of Truth, in 2004. The book unfolds a gripping story of perhaps the first case of assassination of a world-class leader by a human bomb. At the invitation of Interpol France, he made an audiovisual presentation of the investigation before an assembly of top police officers, Buddhists and Jain in Tibet, China. He also visited Jerusalem, the holiest city for Christians and Jews and the second holiest place for Muslims. He travels widely and addresses gatherings in educational functions where he speaks on socially relevant subjects such as values, human rights, leadership, crisis management and investigation. Mr. Karthikeyan presently holds the position of Director General, National Human Rights Commission of India. We welcome you, sir. And for further proceedings, I'd like Krunal ma'am.
He holds so many positions and he does so many tough things in life and tackled it very passionately and successfully. How should I greet him and how should I talk to him? But the moment I said hello, and the hello from his side was very polite, and it was just awesome that he made me comfortable to talk to him. Thank you so much, sir, for accepting our invite for this session. Shreya said, she has gone through the entire details and all the CV, we can say, and this is a huge thing that we are having Karthikeyan sir here. I cannot speak up more about Karthikeyan sir, because there are a number of things that he does personally and in his day-to-day life. But before that, I would like to welcome Karthikeyan sir in the hands of Dr. Rajan Venugopal, VC, G.H. Raisen University, with a small memento from our side. I request Rajan Venugopal sir to please welcome Karthikeyan sir with a small memento. Thank you, sir. This is the Chitnavis Center, and Chitnavis Center has been a supportive pillar for the session every time. I request Mr. Mohan Sebate, Director, Chitnavis Center, to please welcome him with a sapling and floral bouquet. I will not take much time.
Namaskar. Thank you very much. No. Not yet. They always ask me. I said no. Maybe after 1 year. They always ask me. I said no. According to me, old age starts at the age of 80, and I have one more year to go to say yes. Thank you very much, the Vice Chancellor, Sergeant Velukar, my colleagues from the Indian Police Service, Sarah and Munnali, and all of you for this warm welcome. Actually, when agreed for postponement of the day, I was traveling, I didn't realize tomorrow is the International Day of Yoga. Normally, I realized the Red Fort. Tomorrow morning, there's a big gathering by the Brahma Kumaris, you know. Last year, I was the first speaker, there were 40,000 people. And then there, I said I made a commitment here. And we are meeting on the eve of the International Day of Yoga. In fact, in some countries, the entire week is celebrated. Why don't you come here? Come here. Why not? Yes. That would be more comfortable. I don't know. Unless you strain your neck, they say. While the entire world is celebrating, you know, they might have great pride for all of us Indians. After all, millions of years ago, this was discovered by our rishis and munis, by their own practices. And today, the entire world has accepted it. Of course, the entire credit today for spreading this tradition, Indian tradition of yoga, to be accepted by all the nations of the world, goes to Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi, no doubt. But I tell you, I had participated in the International Day of Yoga celebrations in the year 2004 in Lisbon, Portugal. There is one Portuguese yoga master. He is called Amrita Sujananda. He is a Portugal man, but he is so devoted to our tradition and yoga. He is known as Amrita Sujananda. He is a great master, great knowledge of our traditions and all that. So he invited me as a guest of honor for the International Day of Yoga celebrations in June 21, 2004. And every year he has been celebrating it, inviting people from around the world, mostly from Europe. And he has been telling, even then, this day has to be observed as intense day of yoga by the entire world, because this is the most effective way of maintaining physical health, mental health, spiritual health. Not only it will keep you healthy, it will prevent many diseases, and it has a curative value also. Apart from that, it enhances your mental health, and through that you go to spiritual health. And there are people practicing from all religions all over the world used to come. I remember that. Much later, it was in the year 2011, on 4th December, at this instance I had organized a conference on the same subject in Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Art of Living, his campus in Bangalore. And great masters like Dr. B.K. Sangar, he is now in the other world, he's a great friend, philosopher, guide of mine, he left the body 3 years back. And Baba Ramdev and Dr. Nagendra and so many masters, they all attended the day-long celebration discussion. Then we passed a resolution addressed to the Secretary General of United Nations. We said this is the one technology which is the most cost effective, it costs nothing, and it is beyond religion, though it came out of India from our tradition, and is being practiced everywhere of all, even Islamic countries, we know very well, and accepted as beneficial all over the world. And this type of practice will unite the world. So we gave many reasons, and long we all signed it and sent it to the Secretary General of the United Nations, telling please get this resolution passed in the General Assembly of the UN for the world to accept 21st June, that is the longest day, you know, as the International Day of Yoga. Nothing happened. But it was only when Mr. Narendra Modi went to UN, that was on 27th September 2014, when he addressed the first address to the General Assembly after he became Prime Minister, nobody opposed it. I had gone a month later to the UN. I was told that every country is signing it, no country opposed it, not even Islamic countries opposed it. So within 3 months, less than 3 months, that is on 11th December 2014, the UN General Assembly declared 21st June as International Day of Yoga. More than 190 countries have signed it, nobody opposed it, and you know, rest of it all history, you know very well how is being celebrated. That is the power of intention of a person. The same thing we all have been saying. Because the power of intention, he was not making a statement, because I had a meeting with him, when was that? 20th June 2013, just before he became PM. When he was Chief Minister of Gujarat, I am the Chairman of the Gujarat State Advisory Council for this 108 ambulance service, EMRA 108 ambulance service. So in that capacity I go to Ahmedabad once in 2 months, meet the all officers concerned, doctors concerned, then meet the Chief Minister also. I met him a number of times earlier. So that was just before he became PM. He was busy campaigning for the Prime Ministerial ship. You know, he was the Prime Minister candidate of the leading opposition party BJP at that time. So he was there for a I happened to go there, and they said he is not there, but he came for a few hours. He wanted to see us, we went. After 10 minutes, he wanted to talk to me. So, the 10-minute meeting went on for more than 7 to 8 minutes. It's a long conversation about, I took the liberty, he gave me the freedom to ask all questions about all the allegations against him. He gave me the space, how can I ask him? Because remember, we had met him earlier also. And the Art of Living, some Jubilee celebration, Bangalore and all that. He answered every one of them. He took the trouble, he was there only for 5 hours, but he took the trouble to answer every one of them, all the charges, including Gondra, Encounter, why you were not appointed, Lokayukta, why they said what is it, low nutritional, all these things. So I asked him one question that is relevant now. I said, Chief Minister's job is a full-time job anywhere, any Chief Minister. And here you are a man of perfection. You look at everything thoroughly, you want to make everything perfect. Now you have become the Prime Ministerial candidate of the opposition party, BJP. He was already campaigning. He said, even if you travel continuously, non-stop, you can't cover the whole country. India is not a country, it's a continent. And along with that, you are going to perform as Chief Minister of Gujarat also. I asked him, sir, where will you find the time and energy to handle both? He told me, Kartikeya, I get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. 90 minutes of yoga, pranayama, meditation. Every day, I get up at 5. The first charge of my 24 hours is taking care of my health of the body, mind and spirit. I've been doing it from younger days. I don't know what fatigue is. He said, you come at 10 o'clock in the night, you will see me in my office here, home office, or traveling. Why I'm saying this, I make it a point to tell this management, schools, convocations, anywhere, because I consider to be healthy, to be fit is one's first duty. Unless you are healthy, what can you achieve in life? What can you study? And what can you contribute to this family or society? If we are healthy, we are an asset to the family and the society. If we are unhealthy and unfit, we become a liability. Instead of taking care of others, others have to take care of us. Become a burden on the society. So now, anyhow, with reference to the yoga, 2020, he said, I've been doing it from younger days, I don't know what fatigue is. And about it, I wrote even before he became Prime Minister. And I know he does it even today. That's why you are able to see him. You may have differences with him on policies, it's fine. But he is the enormous energy of the man. Continuously traveling. And a man who knows, he is himself proud to say that I was selling tea in the trains. It's a fact of life. See the way he deals with the world leaders, whether it's the President of America, Chinese President, with what confidence and doing it. See, it all can be attributed to this practice of yoga, no doubt about it. See, we are all born, most of us are born. When we are born, we are reasonably healthy. And what we become in life is all in our hands. You can't blame your parents or brothers or sisters or teachers or anything else. If we care, take care of ourselves from the younger days with good practices, satsang, healthy. So we can remain healthy as long as they are destined to live. All of us have to go one day. But till the day we go, we should be fit enough, healthy enough to be of enjoy life. Otherwise, life becomes a burden. My God, you see, sad to see people who are 25, 30, as if it's a big burden on their head. Because the healthy practices are neglected. So it is our duty, not at any age you can stop now. And more than that, we have to convey to the family members at the earliest. They can start at the age of 5, 6 also, you can do it. Then if it is done in the family, the children also grow in the same atmosphere. After all, the values we are talking about, I would say the first value is to be healthy. First value is to be healthy. First duty is to be healthy. First right is to be healthy. Otherwise everything else will be, we'll be wasting our life. It doesn't apply. So, and this is a Diksha Bhumi, no? Nagpur is Diksha Bhumi. For many things, Nagpur is famous. Orange city, orange country. And is the sub-capital of Maharashtra. And is claimed as one of the cleanest cities in the country, according to the survey arranged by the Government of India. And it's also a green city, isn't it? Supposed to be the green city, though it's the hottest city. But today, Dr. Nirmali has ensured the weather is reasonably good for me. I'm happy, it's very pleasant, better than Delhi in any case. So, I kind of compliment all of you for being fortunate to live in this beautiful city. And I compliment the SGR Knowledge Foundation and the founder, Mr. Sunil Raisoni, and the foundation for the rural objective in organizing. You see, every step is important. Like, only drops ultimately make the ocean. It is the sand particles which make the mountains. So every one of these activities, whether it's addressed by 100 people or 200 people, is important. Even if it touches the heart of one person, if there's a change in the life of one person, you know, it's worth the trouble. All of us are doing it and probably coming and going and all that now. Now, I can do no better than quoting some of the greatest personalities on the importance of values. Now, the one proverb, you know, which is repeatedly quoted by my friend, philosopher and guide, Dr. Abdul Kalam. You know, even when Mr. Pranab Mukherjee was President of India, I met him and told him, I said, sir, I admire you for the tribute you paid to Dr. Abdul Kalam. What is it? He said, he was sitting president. I said, sitting president, you say, Dr. Abdul Kalam is people's president forever. It's a big statement. Coming from the President of India, who is the then President of India, but he said, this is not true, it's true. But such a word coming from you shows what a magnanimous person you are. No, I only said the truth, he said, no. So he used to, you know, I'm sure you have heard it a number of times. He said, if there is righteousness in the heart, there will be beauty in the character. If there is beauty in character, there will be harmony in the home. When there is harmony in the home, there will be order in the nation. And when there is order in the nation, there will be peace in the world. But he says it starts with righteousness in the heart. That is the heart full of right values, actually. And Mahatma Gandhi, the greatest personality of the last century, accepted by the world, he said, our values become our destiny. I quote him, your beliefs become your thoughts. Our thoughts become your words. Your words become your actions. Your actions become your habits. Your habits become your values. Your values become your destiny. It becomes your destiny, my destiny, the nation's destiny also. Now the greatest scientist of the last century, Albert Einstein, I will quote him also. He says, possessions, outward success, publicity, luxury, to me, these have always been contemptibles. I believe that a simple and unassuming manner of life is best for everyone, best for both the body and the mind. Well, the whole world accepts Confucius as one of the wisest persons ever existed. I quote him. He says, if a man carefully cultivates values in his conduct, when he says man, it includes woman. If a person carefully cultivates values in his conduct, he may still err a little here and there, but he won't be far from the standard. And again, to quote Mahatma Gandhiji, he says, if wealth is lost, nothing is lost. Health is lost, something is lost. But if character is lost, everything is lost. Both, best of all things is character, according to him. So health, as I mentioned to you, is an important value. I am again quoting Mr. Narendra Modi, again and again he says, unless we are healthy and fit, we can achieve nothing in life. Not even peace of mind. So an important value is to promote health and fitness, that of the body, mind and spirit. So also environmental health, financial health and emotional health. Webster's dictionary says, a set of values is what guides a person's life. Now, go to quoting Fortune magazine says, you to become a leader you must have values, otherwise you remain a manager, whatever may be your position. The manager administers, the leader innovates, manager maintains, the leader develops. Manager relies on systems, the leader relies on people. The manager counts on controls, The leader counts on trust. The manager does things right. The leader does the right thing, right thing. That is, a manager with lot of values about which we'll discuss, he becomes a leader, that's all. The manager transforms into a leader when he has imbibed all the values. In the end, the quality of the values we embrace and the intensity of our commitment to them determines the level of our accomplishments in life, personal life, family life, societal life also. So the values and attitudes we live by affect how we relate to other people and to all our activities in the environment, and so are a major influence on our prospects for achieving a sustainable future. So what are values? A well-defined value system is a moral code. One of the unique characteristics of each single person is his or her value system. Knowing our own values and priorities is very important for personal growth. Values drive our lives, are actually a special power in the universe. The spiritual principle of oneness is recognized by our minds as values of cooperation, integration, teamwork and others. Likewise, the universal principle of love expresses through values of goodness, selflessness, self-forgiveness, self-givingness, openness, tolerance, respect for others, and a number of others. You know, in the last 25 years, we have seen an explosion in an interest in values, because we see the values going, disappearing, and that's why turbulence in personal life, family life, society life, growing violence, intolerance, even growing divorce in families, and you see in wealthy countries like America, children taking guns and shooting each other. Well, I don't have to talk about what's happening in our own country. Every day, the television and headlines and newspapers bring. So, we realize the importance of values. Religious leaders speak of family values. Nations speak of moral values. Spiritual teachers speak of the highest values of gratitude, benevolence, tolerance, compassion, love, and service. Values motivate us, move life, move us forward. Now, tolerance, openness, respect for the individual, teamwork are several great human values, while oneness, love, beauty, truth, and compassion are higher spiritual values. At certain points, the human and spiritual values come together and blend into one another, expressing through spiritualized human values such as self-givingness, gratitude, service and compassion. So values are expressions of emotionalized truths that when implemented energize whatever they come in contact with, enabling the greatest positive results with the least effort in the shortest period of time, whether it is for the individual, family, collective, or the society as a whole. So values are call of the divine to the minds of men to seek a better life, to pursue ultimate delight and fulfillment in life. So how is the values acquired by the society? Society acquires values through a long process of trial and error, experimentation with various approaches to life. Over years and centuries, the collective comes to recognize that certain principles or guidelines are essential for the survival, are vital for the growth of the individuals and for the community to exist in harmony. They learn by experience to value these essential principles and pass them on to future generations as cultural guidelines for action. They discover that cleanliness is essential for health. Punctuality and regularity of action are essential for success in everything, including farming, agriculture. Honesty and truthfulness are essential in trade. Loyalty and patriotism are essential for the integrity and defense of the nation. responsibility, generosity and self-sacrifice are the bedrocks of the family. They recognized that the more you strive to live by these values, the higher you rise in consciousness, and the more higher spiritual consciousness enters your being and expresses in your life. The value of honesty is a reflection of the spiritual value of truth. Now, harmony, for instance, the value of organization. Harmony is such a noble, elevated value. Concern for others. Perhaps the single most powerful way to succeed in life is to have more concern for our fellow beings, members of the family, neighbors, and with whom we work, with people who work for us, and even outside the community. Hard work. It is universally agreed that hard work is one of the keys to success in life and work. Then continuous improvement and progress. We all keep learning, continue to learn till the very end. Respect for the individual. One of the most significant personal values to look on every person as a special, unique individual. This form of deep respect for such person has the power of generating goodwill, great happiness and great achievement. So a value ultimately is a belief, a mission, a philosophy that is meaningful. Whether we are consciously aware of them or not, every individual has a core set of personal values. Values can range from the commonplace, such as the belief in hard work and punctuality, to the more psychological, such as self-reliance, concern for others. When we examine the lives of famous people, we often see how personal values guided them, propelling them to the top of their fields. Whatever one's values, when we take them to heart and implement them in the smallest details of our lives, great accomplishment and success are sure to follow. I used to take the liberty of telling Dr. Abdul Kalam, I know him for a long time, for 4 or 5 decades. I used to tell him, sometimes we discuss very frankly. I told him, sir, you are not the greatest scientist in this country. There have been people of equal eminence. Ultimately, why people admire you, worship you, is because of the values, sense of integrity, simplicity, humility, concern for everybody. Once I remember in Pune, I was on the board of the Mumbai University, so we had a program there. After that, Mr. Rahul Bajaj had invited him at 4 o'clock for a gathering of top industries, about 4,000 of them were there. After the symbiosis function, I went away. 4 o'clock, 3:45 I was there. When the President Kalam came at 5:30, then Rahul Bajaj told me, he knew I was close to him. He said, Mr. Karthikeyan, we are all admirers of Dr. Kalam, but tell me, the President makes 4,000 busy people wait for 1.5 hours. How will we reach 20:30 help India? I said, I'm going to convey it to him. So the same night I spoke to him on the phone, I told him, sir, you have made 4,000 people wait. One of your great admirers, don't mistake him, said like this. He said, what can you do? You know, the students, he said, I have a weakness for students. But the students around me, I cannot dismiss them. I have to answer every one of them. But I said, but even then, this is one failing of yours. Then I told his personal staff, Sheridan and others, I said, don't keep too many engagement for the President. The President should be on time. He agreed. He said, yes, I should be on time. He was prepared to be such a generous man. He said, sir, what can we do? He cannot say no to a student. It's a great quality. But at the same time, see, he was respected even today. I went for the inauguration of the memorial by the President Prime Minister. And you go there, thousands of people come to the memorial. I went to Rameshwaram temple, when I go there, the people in the temple said, after the Kalam passed away and memorial, isn't there 10,000 more people are coming to the temple also, because many people come for that also. See, he is respected, admired, remembered even today for the values of the man. I used to tell him, you are not a greatest scientist. You are a great scientist, all right. But in the value of the man, it makes all the difference. Politicians also, you see, Mahatma Gandhi. Do you respect all the politicians? No. You respect those who observe values. Same with the police officers also. See, you have to stand by certain integrity is very important, impartiality. Independence is a very important value. I tell you now, deviating from that, one episode, it's not correct for me to say, but it happened in life. You know, I was investigating, some people asked me to speak about it, but I thought I will quote question answers. But about that independence, power of independence, I wrote this article. When the CBI had this Golden Jubilee celebrations, they brought out a souvenir. Then the CBI asked me, sir, please write an article. I said, we have done so much about investigation, what do I write? No, something which is not known to others. I wrote the article, Power of Independence. Number of episodes in my life, but one episode was there. You know, I was investigating Rajiv Gandhi assassination. When I entered the service, I took a decision, I will not seek any favor from anybody. Wherever I'm posted, I will go. Whatever is the position, I will go. I will not seek a favor from any politician or a posting, or to avoid a posting. That all happened throughout my life. One incident was, you know, Rajiv Gandhi was killed, you know that very well, 21st May, 91. I was in Hyderabad, I was AG of the Center of the Police Force. Call came from Delhi, telling everybody feels you should take up the investigation. Though it's a blind case, the director CBI said, it's going to be, it's not, unlike Mahatma Gandhi and Indira Gandhi assassination, that people were caught red-handed. The investigation was only to pursue the matter further. Here, both the RAW, dealing with external intelligence, and the IB, dealing with internal intelligence, same, we have no clue. So it may end up as Kennedy assassination. I have written all that in the book. But the government wants us to investigate. So we feel you are the right man to do it. I said, okay, that is the, and he said also, it may resign mystery. So okay, that's a call of duty, I'll take it up. But on three conditions, no politics. I will not allow any political interference. And I will not allow any third degree in the investigation, whether the case detected or not. Spontaneously came. Then they accepted all the conditions. It's a long story, I took it short. So one doing the investigation, one person, you might have forgot, it's an old story now. One person whom we had picked up, because we said no third degree, we have to exercise cooperation. Shambhugam his name, Kodiakari, he was helping the LTT to take all these things from here, there and from there to here. And he was cooperating, we dug out a lot of wireless meetings. 2 days, my officers worked night and day. I went and came back. He escaped by having food, suddenly escaped with the office. Then was found hanging next morning. So naturally in your case, where I said I will not touch a person, somebody in custody, who will believe? They think he must have beaten him up. So I told my DAG who was there and became director of the police later on, Vigilance Commissioner also, Street Mark. I said, hand it over to the local police. Do everything transparently. So all that was done. But then, you know, it was the everyday, the news was on Rajiv Gandhi assassination. Parliament was holding on Monday morning. So my director has called saying, the Home Ministry is coming to Madras. Monday, Parliament session is there. And he will want to talk to you. So he came all the way. And he wanted to visit the place. He said, I want only Mr. Karthikeyan. We have a helicopter. He could not land. He came back, 8 hours with him. While coming back to the Madras airport, he told me, please suspend all those people who are in charge of the person. I told him, sir, why? no, how do we face the parliament? I said, neither in the CBI, at least those days, we are never told how to investigate. CBI investigation means you record evidence and file the charge sheet. You don't even arrest those days. And here is a case where to do the tracking, intelligence, tracking, following it up, do the operations. Neither the CBI nor the police academies were taught all these things. And my officers have done it beyond the call of duty. 48 hours I have been, because I am involved, because I work like that. So I cannot suspend them. It is true. But we have nothing to do with, let the police investigate the wine shop, we will purpose. No, but how do we face the policy? I told him, sir, it's not possible. Home is Mr. Chavan. I tell him, I will not be able to do it because it is not their fault. If I have a problem, I will take full responsibility and quit. Or whatever you want to do, you do it with me. I told him. So when he came to the airport, press people came, he said, no, they have done a great job. I rang up Delhi, told the then director CBI. I said, I think they are going to announce some suspension tomorrow in the parliament. If it happens, I will quit. I did not ask for the job. I have agreed on being persuaded. Because how can you sacrifice somebody without finding? There will be an inquiry. There is a fault. And then he went to the Prime Minister and then it was stopped, although we had to take some abuse in the parliament for some time and all that. I stood firm on that. Like that number of things, you know. Because, you know, you have to stand on some principle. Power of independence. I said, when Dr. Kalam became President of India, I knew him very well. He used to come home. Very day he called me like this. He told me, sir. I said, don't call me sir, sir. You are elder to me, you are a president. We used to call, no, in Tamil Nadu we call like that. No, no, we are friends. You have done the greatest service to the country. They were about to kill you. Your wife had a heart attack. I am the President of India. What do you want to become? The nation owes a lot to you. You want to become governor, ambassador? I was overwhelmed. The man became president yesterday. He is concerned about me. I said, so nothing. I did my duty to the nation. And there is no compensation for what I have done. I was very firm. He said, no, consult Kalama, my wife, and tell me tomorrow. I asked her, she said, you never ask for a favor from anybody. Nothing is worth asking for and getting. I said, tomorrow the president will call me, what do I say? Please ask him to take that his health, go for a morning walk and all. Something more which I don't want to say, because he started laughing at it. Really. Told him, he said, why? I said, Dr. Manmohan Singh has respect for me. I can ask him, he will do it. Or you will ask, he will do it. Then why are you not asking? I said, if I ask him, he will do it, make me a governor. Tomorrow, he won't ask. His party will ask me to do something with the chief minister, which is not acceptable to my conscience. If I ask for a favor and become, I have to do it. Otherwise, I am guilty of ingratitude. If I do it, I lose respect for myself. So he used to remind me 2-3 times and then gave it up. I said, no. So when he told my colleague, they said, you are a fool. You should accept it. I said, no, I have no regrets. I have no regrets. What is there after 3-4 years again? You will cease to be. I tell my colleagues also, don't make compromises. Not on basics, at least. It's difficult. It's a difficult decision, but you have to be very firm in that. I have maintained it from the day I entered service, a number of episodes. I don't want to say that. So I thought it was just came to my mind because I see number of officers sitting here in uniform. It is the toughest job, you know, police job is the most difficult job. You will see all hard work done, risky everybody. 1,000 policemen get killed on duty every year. 1,000 policemen get killed. More than all the killings of army men in wars. And when you are celebrating Deepavali, they will be on the road. And the Central Reserve Police Force, in which I have functioned, they will be travelling from place to place. They will not get even the letters because they will be moving. I told Mr. V.P. Singh, Prime Minister, one of the companies moved for 54 times in a year. So the letters will not go to them because by the time they go, they are already moved to some other place. So it's a very, very difficult job to do. Some people do wrong things, some people do wrong things everywhere. Tell me a walk of life where everybody is perfect. So you can't forget it. So I always deny that. Don't presume that what they do is wrong and all that. So we can energize our lives, ladies and gentlemen, by making the full effort to implement the values we subscribe to. Once we identify values that are meaningful to us, we can develop strategies to implement them. So like this, many of us have come, I declined it because I am very clear in my mind that whatever is given to me, I will only follow certain things because for me, I must respect myself. Ultimately, the only thing with which we bond with us until we go to the grave, you know, our parents are there, but they go mostly before us. Friends come and go. But the only thing which is with us till the very end is our conscience. As long as we are happy, at least with our conscience, life can be peaceful and happy. Whatever may be your income, whatever may be the position, you will see it ultimately. The people who do shortcuts, you see these Modis and Malias and all that, what type of life are they leading? They have duped the nation, duped the banks, running. Well, they can see successful. What is that life? So, just a few of the values I would suggest is accountability. You should try for accuracy. You should peace. Accept all challenges. Agree to all changes. Cleanliness, orderliness. Collaborate. We cannot live alone. We have to collaborate. We live in a society within the family and with others also. And our communication has to be honest. Concern for others should be there all the time. I told the Home Minister, I will take responsibility. I am not prepared to suspend. He said, at least the inspector. I said, no. I will not suspend even the constable. He was very good. Home Minister was very good to me. Later on, Mr. Kshatriya, who was the Chief Secretary till recently, you know, now he is also heading a commission, right to duty or something. And flight he met me. I didn't recognize him, but he said, sir, Mr. Chauhan, those days, you know, when we investigated, a lot of controversies were there. In meetings, he will say, I didn't know that. Only last month he told me, Mr. Chauhan ultimately said, what does Mr. Karthikeyan say? Okay, what he says is that. I was so happy to hear that. Only last month from Kshatriya, who was a personal secretary to Mr. Chauhan for 5 years, he became chief secretary and all that. Regularity. People should be able to rely on you. Your subordinate should rely on you. Your family should rely on you. We can all make mistakes, but we can change. We can change always. There is no one who has not committed a mistake. But as long as we realize we had done a mistake, and say, I will not repeat it again, you have become noble. You see the history of all the saints also. Most of them have gone through bad periods. But they have changed. They said, honestly admitted it. It's possible. We are human beings, and good and bad thoughts arise in all of us. Nobody can say that we never had a bad thoughts. But you know, that is why the meditation helps you. What thought analysis? You look at yourself, you look at your thoughts. When I tell you honestly, everybody will have, you know, negative thoughts also. When your thoughts, you think, is this going to do good to me? Okay, it gives me pressure now. Is it going to do good to me in the long run? If it is not, avoid it. You can. Or if it is good to me, is it going to harm somebody else or the environment? Avoid it. So entertain only those thoughts which are good to me now, in the long run, which are not harmful to others. All of those thoughts, I tell you, we can train our own minds. Ultimately, we make our life heaven or hell. It is in our hand to see whether I am making or escape. If you are not doing wrong thing for somebody else, you are the king, you are the master. You oblige one person for some favor, you have become a slave, you have lost your independence and all that. So, like that, you know, goodwill, goodness, gratitude, hard work, independence, maximum utilization of time is very important. Only 24 hours are given to us. So how do you use the time? Mr. Modi told me, first charge on these 24 hours is 1.5 hours morning, yoga, meditation, like that. Time is valuable. You have no time to waste. Time is the only thing we cannot get back. Everything else you can get back, you know. And no use regretting towards the end of the life, oh my God, I could have done this and that and all that. We can back it. And punctuality, regularity is very, very important. Reliability, respect for others, rule of law, self-reliance and all that, simplicity. You know, the humility. The higher you grow, the simpler and humbler we should become. I have not seen a person who is humbler than me, Dr. Kalam. As President of India, I tell you one episode, I can't help it. Because one day in a function in Rashtrapati Bhavan, after the event, always there is a big tea, high tea. He goes there and he is the host, but they give a plate to him. They put a vada in his plate, obviously, he likes it. We were about 200 people, ministers, ambassadors, everything. Myself, my wife were there. She was at a distance. He walked towards her and gives a plate to her. Everybody is watching. He tells her in Tamil. She says, yeah, you take, happy take. No, you are my guest, I am the host here. And not only that, see the graciousness of the person. He says, Amma, the food is a big relief, but nothing like your food. We give very simple food to him. See the grace, humble man. One day he calls me, after 6 months after becoming the President of India, late in the night he calls, those days, you know, midnight. He eats dinner at midnight or later. He said, sir, I was stuck in Tamil. I had slept actually, but how can I say I had slept? No, sir, I was sleepy. He said, when did we meet you? When did we first meet? Was it in Hyderabad when you called me for a talk in your IGCRPF? I was still recovering. He said, no, 10 years earlier. I came to Poyas Garden in Madras City. He is already President of India almost a year. He said, I came. There was a police guard in the ISRO guest house. They told me, Mr. Karthikeyan is there upstairs. I looked at the watch. He said, we have not met till then, but I was your fan. I used to do a lot of activities, you know. I always wanted to see you, but it was midnight, so morning he came and knocked the door. All this written, I narrated in his presence later on. He said, there was no response. So I was going back, they said, no, I must meet you today. No, you open the door. He tells about an incident which was 40 years before that. He said, you were wearing a dhoti. You know, dhoti means, you know, in the south we wear this. You were wearing a banyan. You had a holy ash on your kirnir, we call it. He said, I am Abdul Kalam. Then you recognize me. I am sorry, I was in meditation. He said, sir, why are you thinking all these things now? He said, no, the evening when I went for a walk, I was thinking of you. He said, when did we meet this man first? He said, I narrated this incident in a number of places, here and abroad, to tell people you must have some spiritual practice. To that I say, I am a good friend of mine. He is an eminent police officer. There is nothing he cannot do. But when I first met him, he was in meditation. See, I am talking about the humility of the person. So the higher you go, humbler you must become, simpler you must become. So decisiveness, patriotism and all that, you know, all is there. Now individual values are private principles, each one of us have. And universal values are on the top of the list. What is important to each one of us about life in general? Good health and physical fitness, I mentioned to you. Sense of accomplishment, fame, mental vitality, etc. Relationships. What is the most fundamental of all values in your corporate or even personal life? Relationships. Relations with yourself. Harmony between your own body, mind and spirit. Unless I am collected, I will not respect myself. With your family first. And then relationship with your colleagues, subordinates, juniors. Relationship with corporates also. The most successful man is the person who can maintain relationships in all situations. And work ethics like challenge and all that. Financial, what's important regarding finance, going nice things, but living within your means. Not borrowing, not on this plastic money and all that. value education is so important, which we are neglected today. Even when I was in the school, I went to a village school, there used to be some old classics, you know, two lines. That's all gone in the name of secularism. We have removed all values also. It is nothing of secularism, talking about values, universally accepted values. What we are talking about is common to all religions, religions and all that, unfortunately. And the values, of course, have to start with the family. The parents, the children learn the values with the family and then the school and all that. Then cultural values are important, or the social values of the day. But these differ from time to time. Once upon a time in Mahabharata time, it's all right for a woman to marry 5 husbands. Or even till recently, in many countries, many systems, a man can marry many wives and all that. At that time it was observed. Cultural values go with the time and the place, but they are not universal, not valued for all time. Now today you can't do it. Now you have to respect. You give equal right. There was a time when we worshipped women. And thereafter we subjugated them, made them slaves. Now again, the time has come, cultural values are changing. So when seen in the light, cultural values have the advantage of becoming a source of insight to their time and society also. Universal values is what reveal the essence of human condition and all that. These values are so important. We link ourselves with humanity and the cosmos. Through these, all barriers of time, place and ethnicity are eliminated now. To meet the challenges of the current century, some of the personal values, I will shortlist them for successful in family life, in official life, in society life, in the nation. Integrity and character is applicable within the family, everywhere. A positive attitude. See, we have no control on things around us. Situations, we have no control. We have no control even on members of the family. If you think of it deeply, husband, wife, children, parents, or colleagues, but we can have control on response to situations. People will behave the way. Situations will occur, but how do they respond? You should be master of your own reaction, your responsiveness for that, the courage to manage the self. We all will go through ups and downs in life, but you must be able to accept them as challenges, as stepping stones. You can take it as come to strengthen you. I have gone through so many challenges in my life. Yes, momentarily you get disappointment, disillusioned, depressed, but you must recall yourself to say, well, this has happened to me to make me stronger, face life. What happens, some wrong is done to you, you should take determination, I will not allow this to happen. I will not allow this to anybody else. For that I can give many episodes if there is time later on. Moral rectitude, compassion, have compassion for yourself first. Forgive yourself. I can't say I never had a bad thought. I never had a bad word. I never intended to harm anybody. But can I give you a guilty feeling? I can't live with guilt. If I live with guilt, resentment, anger, jealousy, ego, these are the causes for some of the deadly diseases, chronic diseases. Science accepts it. 90% of the diseases, they are psychosomatic. So if you live with the negative thoughts, they will result in cancer. You see, in the age of 25, 30, people have cancer. All types of diseases, new diseases are being discovered. So you should resolve these differences. The anger will come. You convert it. You should be able to resolve. Think over. That's why meditation helps. Thought analysis helps, as I told you. It helps. Watch yourself. Don't allow resentment, anger, resentment. Don't wish ill for others. It's like, I want to harm somebody, anger. Taking a burning coal and trying to throw at the other person. That may hit him or not, but it's already burnt my hands. Same thing, the negative thoughts, the anger, first harm me. Whether it affects the other person or not, it's a different matter. So forgive us, don't live in guilt, and forgive the other person. Because if you just think of, just imagine,